Abhishek's question is, we have read about the little man, we have read about smallness and greatness. Now I understand what greatness is, but can there be a way to maintain it? Can there be a way to maintain it? Assume in Abhishek's question, given imagination, that greatness is something that can be brought forward from the past or rolled over into the future. And it is no wonder that such an assumption has come over to this mind and maybe to the mind of many others. After all, don't we call persons as great, Akbar the Great, and Ashoka the Great, and a thousand others whom we have labeled as greats? Once you have labeled somebody as great, then the assumption is that that fellow is perennially great. You understand? When you say somebody is perennially great, you mean that his greatness is a constant. That his greatness is a constant. And then there are people whom you have labeled as outright sinners, as people who can never have and never had any contact with greatness. You have made greatness something that runs across time. Let me say something a little bit different from this. Greatness can never exist across time. Greatness is always in the present. Greatness is not a person. Greatness is a moment. Greatness is not a person. Greatness is not a quality. Greatness is a moment of attention. In the moment of attention, in awareness, whatever happens is great. Whatever happens is great. And in a moment of confusion, of lack of clarity, of sleep, of ignorance, whatever happens is little and small. Are you understanding this? You can never maintain your greatness. Greatness is a battle that must be fought from moment to moment. You can never say that I have won this war for sure and now the trophy is mine. Now it can safely rest in my cupboard. No, the trophy can never safely rest in your cupboard. It has to be guarded every moment. Because the enemies are there every moment to take it away from you. There is a moment of attention and many of you are attentive right now. And there are a thousand enemies lurking around who can at any moment take your attention away from you. That stray thought comes up to your mind, your neighbor starts fidgeting with her pen or starts whispering a few things into your mind and the attention is gone. Do you see how close the enemies are to you? It's gone. How do you maintain it? It can never be maintained. It has to be one every moment. Every moment. There is no inventory of greatness. There is no inventory of greatness. That I have accumulated greatness and now it belongs to me. No, it does not. I understand this. The only way in which it can be maintained, just to say, for to say that you are maintaining greatness, the only way in which it can be maintained is through perpetual vigil, perpetual awareness. You let go of your awareness, you fall asleep, and you slip back into smallness. You slip back into smallness. The attention must be constant. The remembrance must be constant. One moment you lose it, and that moment is gone forever. Every second comes from nowhere and goes into nowhere. Do you ever know where time comes from? And do you ever know where time goes into? All you know is that the present is real. This second of time is real. There is no question of maintaining it. only this second is real. And in this second, we are active. To extend it, sir, I really want to be attentive, I really want to maintain it, but then there are 100 enemies. Abhishek, have you identified those enemies? Abhishek, have you really in your attention being able to see what is it that snatches away attention from you? What is it that is a source of distraction? In your moments of attention, have you looked into your life and tried to see what are the different forces acting upon you that will not allow you to remain centered? Even at this moment, there is a clear demarcation. There are some of you who are listening, actually listening. And there are some of you who are speaking a lot. And by speaking a lot, I do not mean that they are actually uttering words. But there is like insane chatter going on here. Insane chatter. Completely mad chatter on. And you can either talk or listen. Yes, please. You can either talk or listen. When there is that chatter perpetually going on, then you cannot listen. And attention is gone. The only thing is, the whole process happens so very subliminally. Always under the surface, always surreptitious, that it is difficult to catch hold of it. Unless you are very, very intelligent, unless you are very, very intelligent and effective, it will just catch you unawares. You will think that you are awake, you will think that you are deciding in all your senses, but then the current has already swept you off your feet. Does that make some sense? Do not think of maintaining it, because the very thought of maintaining it takes away attention. Just remain awake. And attention is not tension. Attention is beauty. Attention is real happiness.